You all know that each of the landing crash of SN8 and SN11 were some way or other related to the Raptor engines. SpaceX is onboarding a new generation of Raptor engines in their upcoming Starship to fix these issues. So, what are the changes made to this Raptor engine? Make sure you watch until the end of the video, because today we bring you the updates of SN15's Raptor engines and we analyze what are the changes made to this Raptor engine. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe to Future File to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. On 16th of March, the new Raptors of the Starship SN15 just arrived at launch site. On Twitter, at Cosmic Perspective, and at Espadre and at CNews' Images, and several others shared incredible photos and videos of the new Raptors that were being carried openly without any shield or cover. And this is the first time all three have been delivered at the same time. Previously on earlier Starships, they were carried separately. On a lighter note, if you zoomed in on the picture to the far left Raptor's top, you would see written, "New Raptor, who dis?" This is so unique about SpaceX. They're doing the coolest and most difficult stuff regarding rocket science, physics, engineering, etc., and they're still like space cowboys who are here to have some fun. Now, to the main question, what are the major changes in this Raptor? On first impression, the new ones definitely seem more compact and better shielded. For example, the turbo pump spin start valve seems much more tidy and compact at Raptor's gimbal head. The methane pre-burner is positioned away from the center point of the vehicle rather than facing towards the center point. This new design of Raptors will fit on the new thrust puck. The thrust pucks will take the thrust of the Raptors. In the previous Starships, thrust vector control were directly positioned on the thrust arms. This resulted on Raptors taking a lot more room than necessary, and thrust did not need extra reinforcement and bracing. But from the new Raptor number 56 onwards, the thrust vector control arms are mounted directly from engine to thrust puck itself. This will reduce extra stress on dome and instead deliver it directly to thrust puck itself. A special six-point mount has been fabricated to attach the ram to the new Raptor for the SN15's thrust ram. SN15 will be the first Starship to be cryo-proofed with a ram since SN8 in early October, almost 6 months ago, thanks to the latest thrust puck design. It is a small update that mostly consists of rerouting and simplifying plumbing, as well as tweaking fittings to match Raptor upgrades. But there is a possibility that these small improvements might lead to a huge result. The previous Raptor nozzles were gray-black. Now, they are moss green. These nozzles seem to have some kind of protective coating. Our guess is this coating is supposed to help in corrosion reduction and simplifying the mass production. For the added changes in Raptor design, the Raptor installation process could be longer than usual as engine technicians and engineers install them on the Starship prototype for the first time. But after it's done, the next test will be static fire, and after that, final test flight. The SN15's Raptor is a new generation of Raptor engine. It is designed for better reliability and reusability. It will be the powerhouse of the Starship SN15, and it needs to endure the harsh conditions and work as expected for the entire duration of the flight. If you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video about Starlink on SN15 that is shown in the end screen. See you there!